And we are back, November 6, 2010. You know, saw a couple of you guys last week saying, yeah, man, where's the 64th scale? Well, bottom line for this show is that we show you what we get in. Now, every week, it's another bunch of boxes come in. We try to pick and choose from the stuff that comes in. If we don't get any 43rd, that's it for that week. We don't get any 43rd. Sometimes we get so much of a given scale, we kind of have to say, okay, we can't do all of that stuff in one show. So we do spread it out over the weeks as best we can. Now, 64th scale, those of you guys who have been collecting it from the beginning, you know it's an awesome scale. You also know that over the past couple of years, something's happened. It's become more detail-driven. Not so much features as including little tiny stuff on the castings. Headlights and better wheels and tires, crisper interiors, the kind of things that have brought more collectors into the scale, because for a long time, a lot of guys said, well, it's just not detailed enough. Not an excuse anymore. Now, what's even cooler is that some manufacturers, one in particular, has taken the cars and put them into scenarios, dioramas. That manufacturer is Greenlight. Check these things out. We like these a lot. This is their Series 3 dioramas. There are actually four pieces. I'm going to show you the fourth one in a second. First one is the Road Racers over here in the corner. We've got the Terlingua Mustang going against Roy Wood's AMC AMX. One's a 67 car, the other one's a 72. We've got the Hitchin' a Ride up on top. This is a taxi next to a Ford Crown Vic. Looks an awful lot like an unmarked police car. And over here, we've got the Hot Pursuit, which is a Pontiac Trans Am, which has been pulled over by a Florida patrol car. These are really, really cool. And I'm going to hold up the fourth one, which is this County Roads selection. Now, we've taken this one out of the box so that we could show you some of the details without the reflection of the plastic. These are killer for a couple of reasons. First of all, the models inside these dioramas, the models themselves are really good. Greenlight makes a really crisp 1/64th scale model car. More often than not, has engine detailing. More often than not, has great wheels and tires, which is something that really sells an image in this scale. You know, for a lot of years, 1/64th scale wasn't really up to snuff as far as the casting. Not anymore. They're right there. But they take it a step further. They park these models in these little scenarios, these little dioramas, and they make the foreground meld seamlessly into the background. That's not an easy thing to do. There's a lot of perspective involved, a lot of tricking of the eye, but they pull it off. Check these out. I'm going to put this right over on the close-up. Look at this. How cool is that? Look at the way the foreground just disappears into that tent you see in the background in the trees. It's like being in the woods. Next thing is these figurines. If for no other reason, if you like 1/64th, maybe you're an HO scale racer, maybe you've got a layout. Look at these figures. At a $10 to $12 price point, you cannot go wrong with these things on any level. Now, my question is, okay, we've got a couple people sitting around. We've got what looks like a park ranger asking them a few questions. And over here in the corner is what looks to be a portable welder. So, what are we doing? Welding in the woods? I'm not sure. It's a cool piece. I love the little figures. I love the way they made everything just flow together. That's awesome. Let me pull another one over here. This one, New York yellow cab with what looks like a cop car, just an unmarked. Now, you guys know Crown Vics have gone fleet only over the past couple of years, so these current Crown Vics would have to be either a cop car or a taxi. And it's kind of ironic that this taxi is a New York yellow cab. There's a big thing going on today, as a matter of fact, that they want to bump up the fares in New York by 50 cents for a basic ride. The irony about that is that 50 cents was what the first New York yellow cab charged. It was back in the early 1900s. 50 cents then equaled 12 bucks today. So you can imagine going 12 bucks to go a mile. Imagine that. They've done a really cool job. It's got kind of like a cobblestone effect here, little asphalt going on. And of course, you've got the buildings in the background. And you've got a fella standing next to the cab. Looks like he's about to hail the cab. What a great, great job they've done. Here's the other one, like this, the Hot Pursuit one. Of course, you've got the Florida Highway Patrol hold down that Trans Am. That's kind of neat. Again, the perspective is very cool on these. Perspective is everything. You see the two cars parked? This background goes seamlessly into what looks like the beginning of the 7 Mile Bridge down in Florida. This is a Florida police car, Florida State Patrol, with the Special Service Package, the SSP. These were hot cars. Hot, hot cars. They tried to do the same thing with certain GM products. They apparently didn't like the way the cars handled, whatever the story was. Not to slam the GM product, but they did decide to go with the Mustang instead. They didn't make a lot of them, but I'll put it to you this way. These were so fast, some of them were used to help land the U-2 spy planes. Go figure that. What a cool diorama. What a cool idea these guys had and how well they've done it. Now, check this one out. This is really something. That 67 Mustang going up against that 72 AMC AMX, the Javelin AMX. What a neat thing this is. Look at that Mustang is just hanging on going around that turn. Look how that red striping disappears into the background. How neatly and evenly they've done that with the crowd. Another car cresting the hill behind them. This is great stuff, guys. Great stuff. The price point on these, everything we've been told, is about $10. This is Series 3. So they've got a bunch of dioramas out there. These do have a habit of selling out like that. They disappear from the market very quickly. Greenlight's a really savvy bunch. We have a lot of high hopes for these guys. They're making some good stuff. They're doing some 24th. They're doing some great 118th. We're going to cover everything as we go forward. We'll be seeing them in Nuremberg, I'm sure. We're going to tell you everything they've got.